Hi guys, today here I am here to explain about bug life cycle. So coming to the introduction, what is this bug life cycle? So bug life cycle will start before there is a software testing life cycle. In the testing life cycle, there is a developer sending their code to the testing team. What the testing team can do? They are expecting something about the developer product. And they are checking with the actual behavior of the software. This is in expectation in imaginary, actual in reality. If what the testing team can expecting about that scenario, if that actual was matching or not. If they are seeing, if expectation was matching to the actual, then they can declare as a, here the test case is passed. If they are getting any expectations not matching to the actual, then they can name it as a fail. This fail is nothing but a, when the expectation is not matching to the actual, we can name it as a defect. Defect or bug is, definition wise, any expectations not matching to the actual, we can name it as a defect or bug. Here I am mentioning that ESP as a expectation, and then ACT means nothing but a actual. This is imaginary, this is reality. Now when the tester found any defect, the scenario expectation not matching to the actual, what he can do means, he can send the defect to the developing team. When as a tester, he can send the defect to the developing team as a new status. What is meaning of this new means? New is nothing but a, like a, when tester found any new defect, he can name it as a status, as new status. After he can sending in a new status, the developer going for the assign phase. What the developer can do? Before opening to this bug, he can check that if the defect is genuine or not. Genuine in no sense. So you can see some testers, based on their pressure levels, they are sending the ungenuine defects. They are expecting wantedly. When the testers was wantedly or by mistakely sending any defects to the developer had a chance to reject. What is the chance? Reject is nothing but a, when tester sends any not genuine defects, it will enter to the reject. Reject is also known as not a bug. When the developers rejects the defect, the defects consider as a not a bug. And in the assign phase, there is a another same assign phase. One is the reject. Reject is nothing but a defect is not genuine. And second thing is, defect is okay, but developer had some confusion about the defect. So there is a defect, but we don't know either it is stable or not. In that situation, they are waiting for the confirmation. For that purpose, developer can say the testing team, we are searching for this defect. We can't getting exact answer either it is genuine or not. So that's why in this time they are keeping a status as a hold. Hold is nothing but a probability, 50-50%, may or may not. What they can do after they are keeping one meeting about this defect, if the hold is genuine defect, then it will enter to the open phase. If the hold is not genuine, it will enter into the reject. There is a chance for reject or open. But as per design is a rare case. Why? Because in software industry, day by day or weekly wise, requirements will be changed. In that time, testers are not aware with the latest requirements. In that time, we are getting this type of mistake. As per design means, defect is okay, but the defect is, as per requirement, this defect is not a defect, it will enter into the reject only. As per design is nothing but a reject only. but we can't blame in tester here. Tester prospective is a defect. But coming to the requirement, that requirement was changed. It was happening in a rare situations. Okay. Now reject is okay, but there is a no rejection options. There is a no reject option, no hold option, no as per design option. Here developer was okay. He can accept it. Okay, this is the defect only. Then he can name it as a bug. Here developer will be accepting. What he can do? If the developer accept, if the developer reject, it will enter to the not a bug. If the developer accept the defect, it will consider as a bug. What they can do that bug? They can open the bug to fix. They are going for the open. Before opening that, bug is okay. Now we can see, yeah, okay guys, here we can see in the open time we need to check for duplicate and defer. What is meant by duplicate? Okay, one tester found a defect as a A, another tester also found a defect as a A, third tester also found a defect as a A. These all are defects, but these all are known as same scenario, same defect. So as per developer perspective, he can't ignore these two defects. He can name it as a, these two defects are duplicate. Duplicate is nothing but these two defects are similar to the this defect. So that's why he can give it name as a duplicate. Now the fourth, like in the open phase, there is a another thing. What is meant by deferred? Deferred is nothing but okay, defect is confirmed. In the scenario also, developer have a lot of works. In that time, the defect contain low priority and low severity. What is that? Low priority and low severity. Low priority means nothing but there is a no importance of the bug and there is a no impact of the bug. Priority in no sense important and severity in no sense impact. There is no that much of importance of the bug. There is no that much of impact of the bug. Like we can see, there is a help. Help is the expectation, but we found that HLP. This is the defect only, but this spelling mistake is not that much of impact to the application. That's why we can name it as a low priority and low severity. Deferred is nothing but a postpone. Deferred is nothing but a postpone. So we are saying to the developer, saying to the testing team, I am deferring this defect. Why? Because it is a low priority and low severity. I have minor bugs, so I need to fix that bugs. In that time, he can give me a status as a defer. But the defect is high priority and high severity. All are confirmed. Now it is not a duplicate. Then only he can follow the bug fixing state. What happened means, here developer will be fixing the bug. Developer will be fixing the bug. Now you can see, after fixing thing, he can give a status as it is a bug is fixed. Then what he can do? The fixed one sending to the testing team again. Sending to the testing team again. What the testing team can do means, they are following the retesting. What is the definition of retesting means? Checking the, like recheck the same defect again, developer properly fixed or not. If the retesting, the defect will pass, it will enter into the test close. And furtherly, they are doing the regression testing. If the retesting, we are getting a failed result. So again, the expectation was not matching to the actual. In that time, already we are setting a new status. Second time, we are sending same defect. That's why they are giving a reopen status. Reopen is nothing but a, like the developer was, reopen meaning is, developer was not fixed properly. Okay, so this is about the defect life cycle or bug life cycle. If in the retesting they are getting passed, they are going for the test close. Then we can, like again, we are going for the test close, we are going for the further defects. So this is about bug life cycle. This is about bug life cycle. When the bug life cycle will start means, when the testing team found any defects, when the testing team found any defects in a failed result, then only we are following this bug life cycle. And it is also known as defect life cycle. Defect life cycle. In interviews, they are asking bug life cycle or defect life cycle. Okay guys, this is about bug life cycle. Thank you.